YouTube channel MS Economic Bites. I hope that you all are doing extremely well. Today I will be explaining you about isochore line, which plays a very important role in the theories of production. So without any further delay, let's get started. An isochore line shows various combinations of two factors, factor X and factor Y. We have taken factor X as labor and factor Y as capital, which the firm can buy with given outlay of the firm. Suppose the price of X is given as rupees 4 per unit and the price of factor Y is given as rupees 5 per unit and the total outlay of the firm is given as rupees 200. If the firm goes on buying only factor X, which is labor, then he can buy 50 units of labor because the price of X is rupees 4 per unit. So 4 into 50 gives us rupees 200, which is the total outlay of the firm. Similarly, if the firm goes on buying only factor Y, which is capital, then he can buy 40 units of Y because the price of Y is given as rupees 5 per unit. So 5 into 40 will give us rupees 200, which is again total outlay of the firm. So by joining these two points, that is A1 and B1, we get a line which is called isochore line. Now isochore line shows various combinations of two factors which the firm can buy with given outlay. Here the total outlay is given as rupees 200. So any point on this line will cost rupees 200 to the firm. Suppose the firm goes on buying 20 units of Y and 25 units of X with the given prices per unit. So for 20 units of Y, it has to spend 20 into 5, which is 100, and for 25 units of X, it has to spend 25 into 4, which is 100. So by adding these two, that is 100 plus 100 is 200, which is again the total outlay of the firm. Now suppose the outlay of the firm increases to rupees 300. Earlier it was 200. Now the outlay of the firm increases to rupees 300. So now the firm can buy more of X or more of Y. The firm can buy 75 units of factor X, which is labor, because only the outlay of the firm has changed. The prices of X and Y per unit is constant. That is, price of X is rupees 4 per unit and price of Y is rupees 5 per unit. Okay. Now, since the outlay of the firm has increased to rupees 300, if the firm goes on buying only X, he can buy 75 units of X because 75 into 4 is 300, which is the total outlay of the firm. And if the firm goes on buying only Y, he can buy 60 units of Y because 60 into 5 is rupees 300, which is the total outlay of the firm. So the firm can move to a higher isochore line if it tends to increase its total outlay. Now suppose the price of X has reduced to rupees 3 per unit, which was earlier rupees 4 per unit. The price of Y and the total outlay remaining the same. If the producer goes on buying only X, he can now buy more of X because 3 into 100, which is 300. It is the total outlay of the firm. Now the producer can buy 100 units of X. Earlier, he he was buying 75 units of X. So it is clear that with the decrease in price of X, the consumer can now purchase more of factor X, which is 100 units.